please join in singing the entrance hymn, number 761, Jesus Christ by Faith Revealed.
Jesus Christ by faith revealed in your gathered church at prayer, in the Spirit giving thanks for all blessings of your care. God with us as life we pray, make your presence known to Jesus Christ by faith revealed in the Holy Word proclaimed, truth in kindling mind and heart, gospel wisdom here acclaimed. God with us as light we pray, make your presence known today.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace and love of God our Father and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My brothers and sisters, this morning we gather as the body of Christ to celebrate the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ in the most holy Eucharist, to prepare our hearts to receive our Eucharistic Lord, and to prepare ourselves to enter into the mysteries. Let us together call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary of a Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you who alone Christ with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption, who live and reign with God the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Remember how for 40 years now the Lord your God has directed all your journeying in the desert so as to test you by affliction and find out whether or not it was your intention to keep his commandments. He therefore let you be afflicted with hunger and then fed you with manna, a food unknown by your fathers, in order to show you that not by bread alone does one live, but by every word that comes forth from the mouth of God. Do not forget the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, that place of slavery, who guided you through the vast and terrible desert with its seraph serpents and scorpions, its parched and waterless ground, who brought forth water for you from the flinty rock and fed you in the desert with manna, a food unknown to your fathers." The word of the Lord.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. Alleluia. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. Alleluia. Glorify the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise your God, O Zion. He has strengthened the bars of your gates. He has blessed your children within you. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. Alleluia. He has granted peace in your borders. With the best of wheat he fills you. He sends forth his commands to the earth. Swiftly runs his word. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. Alleluia. He has proclaimed his word to Jacob, his statutes and his ordinances to Israel. He has not done thus for any other nation. His ordinances he has not made known to them. Alleluia. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the cup of blessing that we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread that we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ? Because the loaf of bread is one, we, though many, are one body. For we all partake of the one loaf. The word of the Lord.
Hallelujah. says the Lord. Whoever eats this bread will live forever.
Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to the Jewish crowds, I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, how can this man give us his flesh to eat? Jesus said to them, amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever.
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. With a little help from above, you feel the power of love. That line is taken from another one of Huey Lewis in the News songs, the power of love. Now, that little quote in between there for us is perfect for today as we celebrate this feast of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, the true manna that comes down from heaven to feed and nourish us and to strengthen us as we go about our journey. And so today we reflect on this tremendous gift that we have the opportunity to encounter and receive, the gift of the Most Holy Eucharist. And so this Feast of Corpus Christi gives us the opportunity to give thanks to God for this precious gift. As we think about that, the power, love from above, the Eucharist, my dear brothers and sisters, is a reminder of God's love for us. As we recall throughout Holy Week, the Lord's passion and death, his love. And then we reflect, my dear brothers and sisters, that every single day on this very altar, when Mass is celebrated, the Lord lays down his life for us. So how do we feel that love from above? How do we open our eyes to the gift that we have in our Lord Jesus in the Most Holy Eucharist? I think we have to approach the Eucharist with the same way our Lord approaches you and me, with humility and love. With humility and love, we must approach the Lord every time we receive him. And we think about that. Jesus chose the humble elements of bread and wine to become his own body and blood, soul and divinity. He changes the bread and wine into his own body and blood because bread represents nourishment as well as wine, drink. Food and drink is necessary for our survival.
And so he gives us his own body and blood. And he chooses humble elements. As he humbled himself on the cross, he humbles himself even today in the most holy Eucharist. He comes off the altar as he came off the cross. And we encounter him right here. And so as the Lord approaches us in humility, we also must approach him with tremendous humility and love. And so how do we prepare our hearts to receive Jesus in the most holy Eucharist? Well, one way we do prepare our hearts, what prepares our hearts to receive Jesus, is a very powerful sacrament that I talk about often, confession. It's such a beautiful sacrament. As we approach the Lord in humility, confession prepares us, my dear brothers and sisters, for communion. And you know, remember last week as I talked about, you know, working with the Hispanic community, one thing you notice about the Hispanic community, not everybody goes to communion. Because their belief, no confession, no communion for many of them. And so they need to be prepared spiritually. And the other thing that they do, and I think it's beautiful, is when you elevate the host and the chalice, this is my body which would be given up for you, do this in memory of me, they recite something. They recite it in Spanish, but what are they reciting? My Lord and my God. They make a profession of belief, my Lord and my God. How we should be doing that every time the Eucharist is elevated and we hear the bells. You know, that's why we ring the bells, to signify that a change has occurred. Something miraculous has happened. My Lord and my God. And the Eucharist for us, my dear brothers and sisters, is Jesus Christ, is the Son of God, is God, who comes to us. And so prepare our heart, and even before the liturgy, I mean, when we think about that, how do we prepare our hearts to hear the word of God and to receive Jesus? We make acknowledgement of our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned. So we acknowledge our sins and we ask the Lord to forgive us. And even before I consecrate the bread and wine, my own words that you may not hear, although even though it's inaudibly, my inaudibly is usually a little bit loud so people can hear it. Lord, wash away my iniquities and cleanse me from my sins. Now, I usually add the word many sins because I acknowledge I'm not perfect and I probably have a lot more than one. So wash away my iniquities and cleanse me from my sins to prepare myself to receive, to offer the sacrifice. But that moment, that encounter, reception of Holy Communion, and this is such a profound moment, my dear brothers and sisters, where I talk about the importance of reverence. And how, as I do this every year, is I talk about the invitation. I don't talk about, you know, what one should do or must do, but I do the invitation and to break down the ways we receive communion. The first way is the traditional way that I give you the option for, and that is to receive kneeling and on the tongue. Kneeling is an act of reverence, and on the tongue is an act of trust. Just like when we were babies, my dear brothers and sisters, we had to trust our mom and dad to put the bottle in our mouth. The same thing. We trust the Lord to feed and to nourish us. The second way is to stand and receive on the tongue. Again, an expression of trusting the Lord. And the third way, and this is one that I talk about that we have to have extreme care for, my dear brothers and sisters, and that is the option that we're allowed to receive in the hand. Now, when we receive in the hand, I've always taught, as I'm sure you've been taught as well, back in grade school, how to receive in the hand, making a throne for the Lord. And we do that by placing our left hand to receive our Lord, and then a right hand underneath to pick him up to receive. To make a proper throne for the King of Kings. And to keep your hands at about the level that I'm showing. Because if you think about it, what does this demonstrate when your hands are all the way down here? Would people watching you and me think we were receiving our Lord and our God? Or if we just put our hands out like this, or we do this, we make a throne for the Lord to receive him into our hands, not to take and not to do any other things like we're begging, but to make a true throne for the Lord, to show our love, and to be cautious when we receive in the hand, my dear brothers and sisters. And, you know, as a priest, you know, I'm truly, as I said, I say this all the time, I'm privileged to be able to hold the Eucharist, to elevate the bread and wine to become the body and blood of Christ. But because I am privileged, I also recognize the danger of that, the danger of taking it for granted. You have to be extremely careful, because I strive at every Mass to celebrate each Mass as it is my first Mass, my last Mass, and my only Mass. To celebrate it with great reverence. Some days I'm better at it than others, but to take and to think about the time period that we're in, we're before our Lord, to be able to encounter him and not to rush through the moment. I think sometimes we become more casual. And casual is not a bad thing, but I think it can also be something that can lead us astray. More humility and reverence to the Lord opens our eyes to the power from above. And so we need to pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that our ears, our eyes, our hearts, and our minds are open to this tremendous gift. And yes, this is a very difficult teaching, my dear brothers and sisters, but it's one that is so beautiful and important. There is tremendous power in the Eucharist. Tremendous power. There's healing grace in that moment. What does Jesus say in the Gospel of John? The bread of life. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. Amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. The power of the Eucharist can never be underestimated. The Eucharist has the ability to bring healing and peace. And another beautiful thing I want you to think about, my dear brothers and sisters, as we celebrate this feast of Corpus Christi, is that we are called to share this message with the world. that this is truly the manna that came down from heaven. This is truly God's power of love rushed into us. But a few weeks back, I can't remember, it was a weekday, my brain goes all sorts of directions, but we had the gospel account of the visitation of Mary with Elizabeth. Now, Mary did not go empty-handed. She had somebody with her when she went to meet Elizabeth. She had Jesus. She was carrying Jesus in her womb. She took Jesus with her to help Elizabeth, who was also pregnant with John the Baptist. When we receive Jesus, my dear brothers and sisters, just like our Blessed Mother, we carry Jesus with us into the world. So the question we should ponder is, who are we going to visit today? Who are we going to take Jesus to today? Who are we going to bring this good news in the message of hope that God loves us? If we think about that, it changes our approach, as it should. You know, for us as Catholics, it should change our approach when we leave here. And think about that. I mean, one, we shouldn't rush out of here. We should take it slow. We should thank God for the gift of the Eucharist. And we have that perfect opportunity today because we end Mass with the exposition of the Blessed Sacrament, Jesus on the altar. So you have the opportunity to kneel and thank God as we process then, you know, silently back to the sacristy. We have that opportunity to thank him. But also as we take Jesus with us, think about that when you pull out of the parking lot or somebody pulls out in front of you. Think about that. Jesus is with you. If you encounter somebody, whether it be going for brunch today or lunch or having to make a stop at a store and your encounter with somebody else, remember you have Jesus with you. If we think about that way with humility and with an open eyes, open ears, open heart, and open mind, it certainly does change our approach. So today, my dear brothers and sisters, with a little help from above, by the power of the Holy Spirit, the Lord is going to come to us on this very altar. And we receive that power. And as we receive that power of love, may we share that power of love to others. We've been blessed with a gift. We are to share this gift. And this is a gift that has the ability to transform our family, to transform our friends, to transform our neighbors, to transform our world. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried,
and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. Christ our Lord gives us his body and blood as real food and real drink, so that we may draw life from him as one Eucharistic community, united in faith. We bring our prayers to the Father.
For our Holy Father, bishops and priests, that they may offer this holy sacrifice with reverent devotion, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in our world, in our nation, in our communities, and in our families, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For deeper devotion to Jesus, really present in the Eucharist, that individuals may come to adore him, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For ourselves at the altar, that we may truly form a single body as we share in Christ with Christ the living bread from heaven, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are struggling with illnesses that impact the body, mind, and spirit, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those visiting our parish family this weekend and for their intentions, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those nourished in this life by the Eucharist, that they may be raised on the last day, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intention of the holy sacrifice of the Mass being offered today for the living and deceased members of the Helen Becker family, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty God, be favorable to the prayers we offer. Accept them in union with the perfect prayer of your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, the one acceptable victim and eternal priest, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
The offertory hymn for this Mass will be hymn number 663. O Lord, with wondrous mystery.
O Lord, with wondrous mystery, you take our bread and wine, and make of these two yourself, our Lord divine. Our wheat and drink become our light, our altar bears your awesome might. O Lord, we thank you for the gift that lies before our sight. Same our Christ and Lord, who blessed the supper room. You are the God who died and rose, triumphant from the tomb. This bread bears your divinity, this cup contains infinity. The mystery fills our souls with love, O Holy Majesty.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. By the mystery of this water and wine, we come to share the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. With humble spirit and contrite heart, accepted by you, Lord, may I say, for the day we visit you, Lord God. Wash away, O Lord, my iniquities, and cleanse me from my many sins. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Grant your church, O Lord, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen in mystery and the offerings we here present, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For at the Last Supper with his apostles, establishing for the ages to come the saving memorial of the cross, he offered himself to you as the unblemished Lamb, the acceptable gift of perfect praise. Nourishing your faithful by this sacred mystery, you make them holy, so that the human race, bounded by one world, may be enlightened by one faith and united by one bond of charity. And so we approach the table of this wondrous sacrament, so that bathed in the sweetness of your grace, we may pass over to the heavenly realities here foreshadowed. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all the hosts of angels, cry out, and without end, we acclaim. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Ronald, our Bishop, and all those who holding to the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or they offer for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, her blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants, and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as ones you are pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith, and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And with your spirit. Let us offer each other this sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep my soul safe for eternal life.
Please join in singing the communion hymn, hymn number 665, Gift of Finest Wheat.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest wheat. Come, give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to eat.
The body of
Christ. As when the shepherd calls his sheep, they know and hear his voice. So when you call your family,
the body
Lord,
of Christ,
we follow and rejoice.
The body of Christ.
You satisfy the hungry heart with
gift of finest wheat.
God, give to us, O saving Lord, the bread.
May the Lord bless you, Father, Spirit, Amen. The body of Christ.
With joyful lips we sing to you,
the body of Christ.
Our praise and gratitude that
the body
you
of Christ.
Count us worthy, Lord, to
the
share
body of Christ.
This heavenly food.
The body of Christ.
Satisfy the hungry heart with gift
of
finest wheat. Come, give to us, O saving Lord,
the body of Christ.
The bread of life to eat. Is not
the body of Christ.
We bless and share the
blood
of Christ outpoured.
The body of Christ.
One loaf declare our oneness in the Lord. You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest wheat. Come, give to us, O saving Lord, the bread
of
life to eat. The mystery
of
your presence, Lord, no
mortal
tongue can tell, whom all the world cannot contain,
come
in our hearts to dwell.
The body of Christ.
You satisfy the hungry heart with
the body of Christ.
The finest wheat.
The body of Christ.
Come give to us, O saving Lord,
the body of Christ.
The bread of life to eat.
The body of Christ.
You give yourself to us, O Lord.
The body of Christ.
Then selfless let us be to serve each other in your name, in
the body of Christ.
Truth and charity.
The body of Christ.
Satisfy the hungry heart,
the body of Christ,
with gift of finest wheat.
The body of Christ.
Come, give to us, O saving Lord,
the body of Christ,
the bread of life to eat.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
body of Christ. The body of Christ. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that we may delight for all eternity in that share in your divine life, which is foreshadowed in the present age by a reception of your precious body and blood, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Just two brief announcements. Number one, next week, we will have our missionary co-op priest visiting us, so he will be preaching at all the masses next weekend, and he'll be celebrating some of the masses. I'll probably do two, and I'll give him two. split them in half, since Father O'Brien will be in Delaware. I invite you to please consider taking some opportunity between 11:30 and 4 o'clock to spend some time with Jesus in the Most Holy Eucharist. Spend some time in adoration. And then at 4 o'clock we will have, I'm going to do a modified procession today in light of, you know, coming off the, you know, bad air quality days and also the high humidity today. Combining all that, we'll just do a modified procession around the church, just the perimeter outside. And also I'm not using incense today till the end, because I know that does impact a lot of people. So to give you a little bit of a reprieve. So we'll sing in adoration and give thanks to Almighty God for this beautiful gift and opportunity he presents to us. Please kneel. O salutaris hostia, quae celi panis hostium, deprecum hostilia, da robeveratis. Patria.